big lie that they're trying to do this to help the children. It's actually a poison, and it can really affect a lot of people negatively, especially people with thyroid conditions. There's 40,000 people that can't have fluoride in their water. Why should those people have to go out and buy bottled water? And there's a whole lot of other stuff that it does to your body. It can weaken your bones. It can shrink the pineal gland in your brain. It can, I know people that have got intestinal infections because of fluoride. There's no reason why we should have this poison in our water. Instead, why not get kids to brush their teeth or to take care of their teeth or get access to dental care? It's, you know, why take this shotgun approach and force everybody to be medicated when it's just a small part of the population that you're trying to target?
Suddenly your food is no longer fluoride free. I grow my own food in the community garden, so suddenly I don't have fluoride free food anymore. There's no way that I can avoid it. As a dancer and a dragon boat racer, I'm always drinking water, lots and lots of water. And that's really concerning to me. It's unnecessary. And then you have to worry about the hydrofluorosilic acid leaching lead from the pipes, particularly in our building, which is old. Yeah. Our building is a, 1907 hotel, and the pipes are old, and the electricity is old. Once you put water fluoridation chemicals in the water, you can't avoid it, you can't get past it. You're watering your gardens. If you have a CSA, we're suddenly using fluoridated water to in our local agriculture, and it gets into the food supply. It's already in the food supply, so we're already getting fluoride. We get it at a low amount and naturally in the Bull Run water. We also get it in the food that we eat. I happen to grow my own food in a community garden, and I'm using Portland water, Bull Run water right now that's not fluoridated, so I can be sure that the vegetables that I grow have a much lower level of fluoride. However, anybody can go online and find, you can go to health-diet.us/fluoride, and they'll give you a top list of 100 foods and with the highest concentration of fluoride. And some of that is because those foods are grown with water that's been treated with fluoridation chemicals, and some of that's because some of those foods get picked earlier they get picked in bulk and they get stored in facilities, and they use a gas to spray into the facility, those holding facilities, that is high in fluoride as a preservative to prevent, and as a pesticide and insecticide to prevent creatures from eating through the skins of the tomatoes or whatever it might be. So there's lots of ways that we get fluoride in our food anyway. Once you add it to the water, this is one of the reasons why so many of our kids between 12 and 15 have dental fluorosis if they're living in areas where they're consuming water fluoridation.